Hi everyone, I'm Deborah Jocklin from the Vancouver Island University Communications Department, and here's what's in the news. There are several ongoing fundraising efforts towards the relief effort in Haiti. A donations table was set up in the cafeteria, management students sold goods around campus, food was sold at recent student union events, a shelter box display and fundraiser was on display in the library, the Jumpin' Java campus coffee shop collected donations, and local actor Cameron Bright, who recently appeared in the Twilight sequel, autographed photos for fans, with all proceeds going towards the relief effort. VIU elder Elsie Paul received an honorary Doctor of Letters from VIU on January 26th at the graduation ceremony at the Port Theatre. VIU Chancellor Sean Atleo said Elsie inspires everyone with her support for higher learning and education. She has spent her life in service to others, in justice reform and social activism, drawing on traditional teachings. Congratulations, Elsie. A graduation ceremony was held for students in VIU's first Aboriginal construction program on January 15th. Lieutenant Governor Stephen Point praised the graduates for their hard work they've put in on VIU's new gathering place, which will be completed in the summer of 2010. North Island College and VIU have signed a partnership agreement that will see both institutions working together to better serve the residents of the North Vancouver Island region. One of the immediate outcomes of the agreement is a dual admissions process to aid the success of students from North Island College who wish to complete their studies at VIU. Convocation ceremonies were held for students receiving degrees at the Port Theatre on January 25th and 26th. It was a great ceremony and an amazing 2 days. Congratulations to all the graduates and best of luck in the future. VIU received a donation from its youngest donor, 5-year-old Alden Tom, who raised money at his 5th birthday party to help the sturgeon at VIU. Instead of asking for birthday gifts, he collected toonies from the kids at his party so he could donate to the sturgeon. Alden raised $35, which he presented to VIU President Ralph Nelson and Dr. Harold Rosenthal, the president of the World Sturgeon Preservation Society. VIU recognized 225 employees for their long service in January, celebrating 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and 35 years of service. I was there myself receiving my 10-year award, and it was a great evening. Congratulations, everyone. The International Center for Sturgeon Studies is under construction and well on its way to completion. The new building will bring together research activities at the regional, national, and international levels, involving the conservation and enhancement of the sturgeon population. The building will be completed later in 2010. Master Carver James Johnny and his son James Johnny Jr. unveiled a 10-meter totem in the library in late November. The blessing ceremony included drummers, elders, and the artists, as well as VIU students, staff, faculty, and the board of directors. We are very proud to have this beautiful totem in our library. Several VIU students, staff, and faculty will be volunteering and working at the Olympic Games. Physical education student Luke Couture will be a member of the ice crew at GM Place, cleaning the ice during the men's and women's hockey games. Some other participants include VIU music professor Alex Sisarev, who has been busy designing the music that will be played at various venues in the Olympic Village, and culinary arts students from the Cowichan campus, who will be working at Whistler's Barefoot Bistro under executive chef and VIU alumna Melissa Craig. VIU will be well represented at the Olympics, and we are incredibly proud of those taking part. Good luck to everyone. And that's a wrap for this edition of eView. For the VIU Communications Department, I'm Deborah Jocklin.